And it says, well, look, now, we don't want to do anything to increase an import. What he's really saying is he is A-OK with cheating. And well, maybe it's really kind of awesome to him to let him rip us off, because maybe he's got his. Finally, our third issue, foreign policy and military might. Our freedom should be the GOP's number one priority. Only one candidate left standing, though, knows that military superiority to protect our interests, and not just piecemeal together some reckless nation-building scheme overseas. It's our military might protecting our interests that keeps us free. The threat of our time is that unwavering and horrid Islamic belief that we, peace-loving, generous Americans, that we are the infidels and that we must die. Well, only Trump talks rationally about listening to top brass as president and hiring the best of the best to work alongside our commander-in-chief, to work with those who share our interest in stopping the Islamic threat by defeating ISIS overseas with strong military strikes and intelligent ops and spurring allies to get more engaged, and at the same time, to keep extremists from using our porous borders that are purposefully left open, using those borders and our visa system to let them come here, where they will recruit to unleash terror here. And it's not something to laugh at, friends. Well, that's just more of that common sense stuff, though, that I guess in campaigns nowadays, that only those independent of big donor demands get to exercise. Hey, there's a reason the big money and open borders and radical special interests are so madly anti-Trump. Think about it. His positions, they're not radically anti-GOP platform positions at all. But they're radically anti-Trump, these folks are, and they're lining up behind the others, because they know that nothing's going to change unless an outsider whom the people support gets in there. Same politicians continuing the same old policies. They're trashing our economy and shipping out jobs and letting us foot the bill for everyone else, palling around with the same old politicos and insiders who've betrayed us over and over and over again. Enough! You deserve better. It's funny, but not really. The same sanctimonious ones lecturing us about Mr. Trump's tone are personally responsible for policies that actually cost American lives and trillions of dollars. Well, enough is enough. Enough of the holier-than-thou lectures from those steering us into rocky shoals. So, an America First foreign policy and smart immigration, where we vet who's actually coming ashore so as not to invite trouble like evil recruits setting up shop here, that is the essence of the long-term strategy to contain evil. That, and respecting our red, white, and blue, making our military second to none, caring for our troops, loving our vets, paying them what is due, like their earned health care, physical and mental health care, and not pretending like tragedy doesn't rage in our military community today. Friends, 22 vets a day commit suicide. 22 of America's finest. See no reason to keep on. Well, I don't hear a lot of other candidates, campaigns talking about our vets, but we are, because we care. Their sacrifices will not be in vain. So we'll elect a commander-in-chief who shares that, and we will never, never leave our men and women behind. And that's why we go to the mat for the front runner. And we won't retreat. We'll reload. We won't retreat, though. And we're willing to stand on the front lines, even, because whatever it takes to defeat The one who did leave our boys behind with no apology, but just a flippant, eh, Benghazi, what difference does it make? That embodiment of all that is so, so wrong with what we're really up against, Republicans. And what we're really up against, well, General George Patton, he said it best. He, leading the greatest generation, he said, politicians are the lowest form of life on earth. He said it. He said it. And he said, liberal Democrats are the lowest form of politicians. So remember what it will take to save our nation. Remember what it's going to take. It's all of us working together at the end of the line here. By God's grace, we will be able to save the nation. And it's going to take unity among patriots who love this country as much as we love our own families. So yes, engage in vigorous, healthy competition. Be civil. Then vote. And I say vote for Donald J. Trump. And then unite to make America great again. And I thank you so much for your graciousness and allowing me to kind of crash your fish fry, letting me come on in and speak my mind about the candidate whom I am supporting. I just thank you all so much for believing in the planks of the Republican platform. We know they are the planks that will build this great nation again. It will build us stronger, safer. It will save our sovereignty. So thank you so much for all of us united in that mission. God bless you, Wisconsin. Thank you very, very much.